So, hi everyone. This is Mukund Sasikumar taking over the Indian Tennis Daily page's official live Instagram page. So, I am here to answer all your questions that you have today. And thank you for joining so far. Hi, Kashyap. What's up? That's VIDHPP. I don't know your real name, but hi. How are you? What's up? How's quarantine life treating all you guys? I'm sure it's a tough situation, but hope you have a good time at home. Hi, Sama. Hi, Satu. How are you? Long time. I wanted to text you the other day to check how you've been doing. Hope you're safe. Hi, Delisha. Ashish. Good question. How many hours of tennis you play and you do fitness? Normally, if I'm in Vienna, I do around 4.5 hours of tennis and 2 hours of fitness on a normal day. Manish and Zaina, hi Z and hi Manish. How are you guys? That's pretty good punctuality. That's really on time. Not bad. A Daft Prig, how are you? I'm fine. Guhan, the legend is here. No bro, I'm not the legend. Many more legends in Chennai. I just found out this afternoon while chatting with you. So, I think those legends will feel bad. Zaina. Hi, Zaina. Nice to answer your questions again. I got pretty nervous when you said you're coming on my live. After 2 years, I've been out of touch answering your questions. Missing tennis courts and it's Veer Pratap. Definitely Veer. Even I miss the tennis courts. It's terrible so far. Manish, love the beard. Oh my god, thank you. Mahalinga Mananta Narayanan. It's very tough without the space to read your name, but I'm good at reading Tamil names or Indian names. Please guide with regard to adult beginners in India. Very good decision because tennis is a great sport, keeps you healthy, and there's no age to play it, I think. So, definitely good idea to start. I would suggest that you take it very slow and don't get very impatient. That you start with probably not too many hours in a day. And yeah, just take it slow, one ball at a time, one day at a time. And enjoy it more than anything else. Vishnu Vardhan has joined, the legend. First of all, thank you so much, Vishnu Anna, for posting a story on your page that I'm coming live. I'm very happy. Although I know you're jobless at the moment, but still, instead of Netflix and chilling, you still chose to be in my live. So, thank you for that. Manat, hi Manat. Long time. How are you? Any new hobby that you have picked up during this break? Ah, yeah, definitely. I guess your name is Vidya, if it's V-I-D-H. Sorry if I'm wrong, but the new hobby I've picked is probably I'm trying to learn to cook some new Indian dishes because I'm not good at cooking Indian so far. So I'm learning it with mom. I learned how to make aloo parathas today. I know how to make parathas, but I don't know how to make the aloo mix. So I learned that today and yeah, I've been learning some new things every day. It is very taxing, guys. Indian food tastes very good, but it takes a mammoth effort to make it. Zaina, I told you I'd be on time. Yes, Zaina, you're sticking to your word and that's one quality I appreciate in a human. Sriram Balaji, Baji! Bala is here. Bullet Bala. Guhan, I'm just happy if that legend doesn't request for my... Ah, Vishwana, you're saying hi to Bala. Yeah, how is Bala? Kanav Kashyap, what is your goal since COVID-19 subsides? Definitely learn to be thankful, just be able to play the sport and not get too worked up with results because this is something that every human has to learn, I guess. So, yeah, and once just to play tennis would be a good goal just for life to get back to normal would be a great goal. Ravi Shankar, how have your goals for the immediate future shifted given the current situations? How have your goals? Not really, but I want to get proper. I really want to get fit, use this time to get physically fitter for the rest of the season, because fitness is something you can do wherever, in your room or in your terrace. So I want to do that, and I want to learn a few new things, because there are many subjects that I haven't really paid attention to that guys my age do it pretty good. Share market, for example, I've been talking to my dad every day about it, to learn some things about it. So yeah, and read a few books, I guess. Veer Pratap, why Indian players doesn't get good sponsorship like the rest of the nations? Veer, that's a very tough question to answer, because you can't pick one specific reason to why tennis players don't get support. And it's at the end of the day, I know I shouldn't probably say this, but tennis is a luxury sport, and there are so many people in India who don't get to eat food like the other nations. That is not too much. So once I'm sure we have sorted those issues out, we can look at sport and all these things, because if you don't do sport, you're not gonna probably die. So we have to sort that out first. So it's also not fair to invest a huge ton of money for sports while you know, things like poverty and women empowerment and so many key issues in the country are not addressed yet. This is just my opinion. Who's just Ram? That's hi Ram. You seem very familiar. I've seen some pictures. I guess you live in the States. Who's the coolest person you have met related to tennis? It would be Mahesh Bhupathi and Vishnuvardhan. Definitely. Veer Pratap again. We do have good talent, isn't it? Yes, Veer, in 1.7 billion people, someone has to be talented. Definitely. Yeah, we have great talent. Not good. Vishnu saying, I have a 2-year-old kid, far from jobless. I take it back, Vishnu. Definitely, you definitely are not jobless. Yeah, my bad. I forgot you have a 2-year-old kid, because you look so young that I can't believe that you're a father and a married man yet. That was a good cover up, by the way. Varunya joined. Hi, Varunya. Willy Matty. Hi, Mahi. Hi, Sunny. And Sandy Kumar, hi Sandy. Hi Duryodhan. G. Vishnu Reddy. Hi Vishnu, what's up? What do you consider as home in India, Hyderabad or Chennai? And usually, where do you train when you're in India? Hyderabad is where I grew up. So, although I don't have my own house in Hyderabad, I have to consider Hyderabad my home, because that's where all my memories belong, and that's where tennis as a sport. I am the player I am playing there. So definitely all my well-wishers, many of them, I'm sure I have many in Chennai as well who are great friends, but still my childhood belongs in Hyderabad, so it would be unfair to not call it home. Hi Druthi, with your association with Coach Martin Sportel, how do you know and how did that association begin? My association with Coach Martin Sportel. So it began like this, that in Chennai it was raining very in China it was raining very heavily. This was I think September 2017, and his player was playing a match after me, so he was just waiting on that court watching my match, and I kind of lost 1-1 to somebody. And once I came out, he said, you know what, you're wasting your life, because you have great potential, but you just move like a cow and you need to get much fitter. And I think if we can work together, we can reach very big heights. That time I didn't take it very seriously. I thought he was just, you know, and also I lost that match 1-1, and I wasn't really in a mood to listen to that shit. Then later, after 2-3 months after, when I was in India, I was having a conversation with my mom, and I told my mom by chance about it, and she said, maybe you should give it a try. You know, if the guy really said that on your face, he must be a very straightforward person, and not many people like that exist, and you should definitely give it a try, and that's about it. So then I met him in Bangkok again, and then I went to Vienna and started training. And Mahalingam sir saying I can help you with regard to stock market, sir, that would be amazing. That would be great. Please send in any information that can help me. I would be very thankful. Vasu. Hi, Vasu. How's the corona life treating you? What's your getaway sport when you take a break from tennis? Tough to say, Vasu. So because I've never really developed any interest for a sport so far. So that is very tough to say. I don't mind watching Formula One actually. I like those. Although I'm shit scared of speed, but still. Satvika, any suggestions for quality life? What can I say? I myself really wondering what to do. Definitely, probably, I don't know. Kidnapping a baby, like a 9-month-old baby, then yeah, even the time you have in a quarantine life won't be enough. So probably that's a good idea. I'll get a dog. But other than that, I don't have any suggestion. Amol Juneja, hi Amol, can you tell us about your transformation from an obese kid? Yeah, I can. The thing is, I always believed as a kid that you can be fat and still make it. Then I went to Spain and I was eating all the fatty dishes in Spain as well. That didn't stop me. But there was this one local tournament that I was playing in Barcelona, and one guy just gave drops and was teasing me. You know, he was putting a drop and then laughing at me and, you know, calling me fat, and he was just more talented than me. And that kind of hurt my ego a lot. That really made me look in the mirror and say, you know what, I'm not gonna let that happen ever again. And from that day, I just stopped eating everything for the next 6 months, and I lost 19 kilos, and that was it. I thank the guy later, 5 years later actually. Vishnu, finally, I know that you have played under a lot of coaches. What do you think clicked between me and Martin is one very big reason that Martin saw the longest picture out of all the other coaches, that Martin is phenomenal in periodization, that he can really decide how something is going to go in 3 months from now. He is unreal in making a timeline. So he just sees everything coming, you know, and he's very good in tackling the snowball effect, and that's very important in a coach, because a mental problem doesn't start big on day one, you know. It starts with one negative reaction or one negative comment from somebody who you shouldn't be talking to. And normally, the earlier the coach spots it, the less issues the player will face as the year goes. And Martin is phenomenal in that. He is very good in seeing the future, in playing the odds. Nobody can predict the future, definitely. But he's very good, he's very experienced in that way to see what's coming up. So he's very well prepared, and he always sees the longer picture. He always sees the bigger picture. And he has every small thing in which I have to improve as a person, as a player. So forehand in 6 months, this is where I want it. Backhand in 6 months, this is where I want it. In the backhand, down the line, cross court. How many technical mistakes I can make in a set, where should it get to at the end of the year. So it's very, you know, there's a road and it's very clear. There's no looking left or right, or I do that a lot of time. I start doubting myself and everything, but Martin's very clear in the journey. Amol, tell us some details about your inspiring journey. When Vishnu is on the live feed, I don't think it's fair to say that my journey was inspiring. I think I had a lot more opportunities than many other guys in India. I'm going to be honest with that. I had great parental support and very good coaches, very good friends. So, yeah, but definitely, if you consider it inspiring, I'm thankful. Tell us some details. I can't really say it in 10 minutes what I can say, but definitely I'm happy with the fact that I've made it so far. I really didn't think I would even be playing tennis at the level I'm playing today 3 years back. So I'm just very thankful for that. If I was starting at age 18, is it good decision for career? Please reply. No, it's not. Clearly, no. For a career, no. You can play tennis to make yourself happy, but it's way too late. Zaina, why are you laughing, Zaina? What? Cheeky. Your best on-court memory. My best on-court memory was beating Vishnuvardhan in Guwahati. I beat that guy finally after losing 7 times to him. So that was a great feeling. I have done many bigger things than that, but beating this guy would be my most favorite moment in one of my most favorite throughout my tennis career. What would you do if someone just basically snatched tennis away from you? Would you possibly go mental? If they snatch it without me reaching my full potential, I think I wouldn't be sane, definitely. Would you possibly go mental? I probably wouldn't be alive, I think. It's too harsh to say it, but I think if somebody would snatch it away before I really achieve things that I'm supposed to achieve, then it's really even tough to imagine it. I think mental is an understatement. Vikas, hi Vikas, how to get into play ITF tournaments? Express the process, please. There's no process for that, bro. Play good tennis and the ITF will invite you to play it. I am Kiran. Hi Kiran. Vishnu, if you were to buy a house in India to live, which city would that be? Mysore, definitely. I really liked it. Depends if some people, by the time I buy it, exist there or not right now. But if they are not in that city by that time, definitely buy a house there because it's very peaceful, for sure. Otherwise, in India, Kunur or Hyderabad. One of these two places. Hyderabad is great, definitely. And also, if you guys are there, would not mind living there at all, especially for the biryani. That's magical to have it every weekend. That's life. Bharat, hi Bharat. Vatsal, hi Vatsal. What you've been watching? What are you watching on Netflix now? I am really embarrassed to say this, but I've never seen a TV show in my life, guys. All I watch is Telugu comedy videos, Tamil comedy videos, and Tamil and Telugu movies and some scenes, and that's about it. I have never seen an English TV show in my life. So I know it's very embarrassing, but that's the truth. So I don't really use Netflix at all. You have been serving pretty great in the recent times. Any specific improvements that you have made? Yeah, maybe. I changed my service action back in December, but even before that, I think I was serving okay. My height helps me, I guess. And thanks to some coaches. Somebody called Rajesh, you know, coached me in Chennai back when I was 14, 15, and technically he made the serve very clean. Otherwise, I don't think I would be serving this good now. Arjun loves life. Hi Arjun, what's your key motivation to play tennis? I just like it, bro. For me, it's like a video game to play it. It's a way of life. Keeps me healthy, keeps me humble. So that's about it. I don't enjoy it, I won't be motivated to play it anymore. I have a dog already and he's 2 years old that says Satvika. Then you're sorted, Satu. There's nothing more to fear quarantine about. Nikshep, the legend. That's a really nice haircut. Thanks, Guru. Jojo Kuma, the killer forehand since under 12. Love it. Thank you, Jojo. Hope you're good. Convey my regards to Basil as well. Tell him I miss him on the circuit a lot. Satvika, wow, 19 kilos. Damn, that's inspiring. No, Satvika, it's just embarrassing that I was 19 kilos more fat. That is not at all inspiring. I mean, losing 19 kilos is good, but you should be asking me why did I have 19 kilos in first place when I was 13 years old and considering tennis professionally. So that goes both ways. Tirtha Sashank, yo, the next gen player in India. Never seen you play, but looking forward to watch you play one day. I've heard a lot of good things about you, and hopefully you keep working hard. And also I think you're Hyderabad's next big name, so we're all waiting to see you in the big league soon. How did your tennis journey start? My dad kind of forced me into it. He put me and said, this is going to be your life so far. So Because of my dad, I guess. Delisha asking me the question. I think this question is very thought by her, and very original question. Nobody asked her to ask it. The question you're expecting: what do you think of the training in Spain? For Indians, not good, definitely. Except for a few particular coaches. Don't get me wrong. Except for a few particular coaches who are very good. I mean, good people and bad people are there all around the world. But I think if you see the overall structure in Spain, they are very successful in tennis because they are phenomenal athletes. But the game is changing now. If you see Yannick Sinner, Tsitsipas, Shapovalov, everybody is smacking the ball huge on the court and nobody grinds from 3 feet back anymore. So that it's not the future. Vishnu Reddy. Hi Vishnu, with all that time you've been in Spain, Austria and Europe in general, any foreign languages that you've picked up? Yes, I speak Spanish. Zaina, what areas in your game would you like to improve in? Zaina is a tennis expert now. She's asking all the top level questions. What areas in your game would you like to improve in? Honestly, this can sound arrogant, but I don't think there's any area in my game that I have to improve in. But there's a lot of areas in my mind that I have to improve in. I have to learn to stay more focused and not get too worked up for results sometimes, not to look left and right in life, try to be more stable mentally and keep your goals stable and try to see the bigger picture always and just stay patient and enjoy the sport, and that I think that will make me a very good player soon. The game, I think everything is sorted right now. It's just how I put it into under pressure. That's it. Amol, not a lot of players choose Austria as a training spot. What made you pick Austria as your training base in Europe? My coach, because he's from Vienna, that's what made me go to Austria. I didn't know either it's great for tennis, but I think it's one of the most underrated places and people should consider it definitely more than Spain. Madhav, what is your message to young players? I know that keep working hard, definitely. What is your message to young players? I would say is, I know that there's a lot of knowledge these days, right? We all have phones in our hand. We all have access to everything in the internet, right? When I was 13, 14 years old, it was tough to check an other player's result. You really need to have a laptop, and at a tournament, you don't have access to it because your mom has a Nokia, whatever basic phone, and if you want to see somebody your age competing somewhere in the world, it was not possible. But now everything is, very accessible. It's in the hand. So it's good that you have knowledge in your hand, but don't let it put doubts in your head. Don't let it distract you too much. Because sometimes in tennis, it's better to have less knowledge. So you just don't know what's happening and you just keep giving your 100%. But when you know too many things, that kind of gets into your head. Vishnu, my best on-court memory was beating you 6-love, 6-love. When did you beat me 6-love, 6-love, bro? I'm sure I didn't lose 6-love, 6-love to you. Unless when I was 6 years old or something. But when was this? Karthik Reddy. Karthik laughing. Why are you laughing, Karthik? Vishnu. But anyway, Vishnu, even if you beat me 6-love, 6-love, it's not on paper. It's not official. So I'll pretend I didn't read that. Arjun loves life. Arjun again, you ever hit a tweener in a match and won that point? Yes, I did. Gary, long time, man. Wow, that's been ages that I've spoken to you. How are you? How's life treating and where have you been these days? Teerta, Shashank laughing. Em nautunavra? Vishnu anna, Vishnu laughing. Rohit, Rampuriya, Vishnu. Yeah, Vishnu is getting a lot of publicity in my live feed. Raghunandan. Hi, Raghu. What do you think about the lack of talent in singles, ATP or WTA? Raghu, it's tough to compare Sania and the talent these days. The sport is much more competitive, I think. Guys are playing really good tennis, man. If you see all the challenges in Europe, when Sania played, it was a much... I'm not taking anything away from her. I think she's a phenomenal player. and she's great, but tennis has gotten a lot more physical these days, and it takes a lot of effort to make it that big. Sania was around 40, right? But I would, maybe this is a sensitive thing to talk about, but I think it takes a bit more than what it took back in 2005 or 6 to be 40 now, because courts are slower and the players, everybody around the world get world-class facilities to train, so it's not that easy. As expected, Mysore, Kiran sir, Pessi saying the best city. No, Pessi, it's not the best city, but I have some good memories there. Why Hyderabad? Because you're there and I know you're going to be unmarried by the time I have 3 daughters and my 3rd daughter is getting married. So that's why Hyderabad, because I know I have your house to chill. Satvika saying biryani is love. Yes, it is, Satvika, definitely it is. Especially I can relate, we both can relate to it, very good. Sheng, hi Sheng, I guess that's your name. What's your real name? Where do you see yourself in the next couple of years? I see myself as a regular player on the ATP tour. Vasu, a loss that you learnt most from? Losing to Vishnu Vardhan in Leonia 7-6 in the third. 6-7, 6-4, 7-6. That loss hurt me quite a bit, and I think I learned a lot from that match, definitely. And one more loss that you learned from most, let me think, because all my losses are, I learned something or the other, so it's really tough to segregate a loss, because there's always something to teach you, but I can't remember. Yeah, Vishnu's match probably. Because you're there, DRC, yeah, you're right, Vishnu. Rishabh Rajan, hi Rishabh, what's up? Long time. What's your favorite shot? My favorite shot, backhand return and backhand down the line. Samanth Parikshit, hi Samanth, how tough is the grind to top 200? Nothing is ever tough or nothing is ever easy in this world or in life. It just depends on how good you are. So if you are good enough to be top 100, then top 200 is easy. And yeah, if you're only good enough to be 300, then top 200 is very tough. So it's just how well you are prepared. Bagi Shri, what's your take on the state of women's tennis in India? Can definitely be better, but that's the overall way how women are treated in India, that we should give them much more opportunities and treat them very equally as we treat our sons, because you know, a guy can easily play until 28, but a girl has to face a lot of questions in the family, and if those things are, you know, we treat them as equal talent, then we would, I think our women's standard would be better or at least the same. But right now, I mean, I'm sure Karman is there, Ankita is there, but can be a bit better. Rutuja is there. All the girls are doing a phenomenal job, but can be a bit better, I think. Vishnu Reddy again. As you mentioned, Telugu, Tamil, comedy, movies, videos. Anyone that you follow in terms of movies, comedy? Brahmanandam, Ali, MS Narayana, Venu Madhav, and yeah, these 4 guys are, I think, legends. Nothing can beat them. In Tamil, not that much. I'm much more into Telugu. I guess there is someone else in Hyderabad now, other than you and me. Is it Vishnu? Who is it? Funniest, weirdest memory on tour, on, off, court. Funniest. I mean, I do some funny shit every day. Like when Vishnu was there, I forgot my credit card in the ATM machine in China. I think if I lost it, I would be in deep shit. He took it, thankfully. So I do really messy stuff on a daily basis. So it's very tough to name one. Weirdest memory on tour. I took a ball and tried to hit the referee once in a NITA tournament, because he was supporting the other guy a bit too much. So, kind, thankfully I didn't hit him because my accuracy was so bad at that time. I couldn't hit a guy standing in front of me, but yeah, that was, I got a warning and I was left off, thankfully. Khatri Hitesh. Hi Hitesh. I saw you practicing at RRC under Nagaraj sir's guidance around 3 years ago. From now, I've been following you. I felt lucky that I saw you playing. Good luck, champ. Thank you, Hitesh. Thank you very much. Jayant, who is the nicest player on tour outside the Indian players? Mark Polmans. Definitely. And Yuri Rodionov. And Lucas Pouvi. Knowledge is divine. Trilok, mental part of the game is very underrated. Can you share one tip on how to improve the mental part? It is not underrated, it's getting very very good off late. Definitely many people are paying attention to it. Can you share one tip on how to improve the mental part? I think definitely if you learn to accept your current position, it makes things a lot easier. And one more thing is to really accept the fact that bad thoughts come to every human on this planet, to every player. So to think that the top guys don't get disturbing thoughts, it's wrong. They get it, they just manage it better. So they will be getting it, but at one point before playing, they know how to say, okay, stop, what am I here to do? I am here to do this, 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 and this is my strengths, and they focus on how to play. So the thoughts that come to you are coming to Novak and to everybody. So that is one thing, one mistake people make is that they think the bad, disturbing thoughts about money or personal life, everything, it comes only to them. That's not true. It happens to everybody in the world. Sania, what is most difficult to you, backhand, forehand or serve? All the three are easy. What is difficult for me is to put the socks in the dirty basket once I come home without getting yelled by mom. That's the most difficult thing so far. Also to take the plate to the kitchen once I eat, because as soon as you eat, you're expected to go at Usain Bolt's feet to the sink, which is humanly not possible. So that's the most difficult things I'm facing right now. But backhand, forehand and serve is tough. What's your plan for 2020 to find an antidote for corona? I'll probably start experimenting tomorrow. Put a bit of paracetamol, some Benadryl in a cup, and you know, to try and make something, and who knows if it works. Ritvik Chowdhury, it's amazing how much you have learned from Vishnu Anna. I guess whatever you are today is because of him. It would be unfair to say whatever I am today is entirely because of him, but he plays a big part. Definitely a very, 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 very massive part if you take out the parents. I would say more than 75 to 80%. As a person, I have learned a lot from him, more than as a player. As a person, he has taught me many, many things. How to be humble, how to be emotionally balanced, how to not treat tennis too seriously, and to just see it as a passion, and to understand the fact that life, I have to, the most important lesson I learned from him is that I should live tennis, but tennis should never become my life, in simple words. Vishnu is your hero, villain until I was 18, because he used to pester me with many things, do this, do that, and you know, don't behave like that, don't talk this, and then my hero once I understood what life is. Vasu, since you travel such a lot, how do you manage your time at the airports? Good question. Tough to manage my time. Of late, I've been traveling with Bala sometimes. If nobody is traveling with me, it's very, very, very tough. Wi-Fi, I guess. Nothing else. I am 17, I like to play TT, and I see my career in the sport. Last 2 years I can't play, and recently I completed my board exam. So can I do this against my parents? Please tell me. No, I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't personally go against my parents for anything in this world, because I think parents want the best for you, and if they feel that, you know, playing TT is not good for you in the long run, or, you know, education is important, that's no doubt. So I think whatever you do, you should do after completing your education fully, and going against your parents, it's not a very good idea. I think, I know you feel different now, but it'll all make sense in a few years. Arnav, how many tournaments a pro player should play on an average in a calendar year? Is it 30? Yes, if you're not winning every single tournament that you play, like Novak or Rafa, then 30 is a good number, definitely. Guhan Rajan, any life-threatening messages you have received after a match? Not a match, after every match. This is really getting annoying, and ADP should do something about it, definitely. It's getting very, 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 very annoying. Regardless whether I win or lose, and that's tough. You know, the betting mafia is really getting out of control. Sir, suggest me the best academy. RBT is very good. Rohan Bopanna's Tennis Academy is doing a great job. I think you should consider it, definitely. Ritvik Chowdhury. Haha, Kiran Anna Rao's roaring people, right? Vishnu, give him a big round. Yes, I am. Give him... Yes, everybody give him a big round. He's an Olympian. Your guys playing Olympics is not a joke. It's massive. Sham. Hi, Sham. I'm a tennis player. Please give some tips to improve. Listen to your coach. That's the best. And enjoy. Gunner Surya. Gun. Surya ji. How did you manage to catch your train from Koblenz to Frankfurt? Hustled my way somehow. Somehow got there. So, yeah. The Guhan, if it was on Instagram, did they mention you or at least tag you? Yes, they did. They sent voice notes also in Russian. I don't know why they thought I'll know Russian, but they did. Yeah. Any suggestions for diet related to tennis? Diet, don't make the mistake of having a specific diet just for tennis. Having a good healthy diet is important for a lifestyle itself. Once you get to 40-50 years old, you really need to, if you want to be healthy, you know, you anyway want to eat healthy. So it's regardless of playing tennis or not, I think one should eat normal. No need to go to the extremes, but you should be eating normal food and not really extreme diet also is not needed. I don't really support that, because that affects your mental health. How to hit the backhand down the line as good as you? I think you will never hit it as good as me. You will hit it better than me when you are my age, and I believe that. Maheka, tell us about your guilty pleasures. Biryani, brownie with ice cream. What else? Food. Any kind of food. I gain weight easily, so any unhealthy food is a guilty pleasure. Tarun Anirudh, most recent piece of advice you found useful? You getting frustrated for not playing tournaments, or why corona happened to you, or why the world is functioning like this is not going to change the situation, or it's not going to help you find a vaccine. So accept it, enjoy your time home with family, because you did not get this in the last 10 years, and you're not going to probably get it if another corona doesn't happen in the next 10 years. So use this time to do all the other things that tennis didn't let you do. And you getting stressed is not going to change anything. So that's the most recent piece of advice I found useful. Adeja, but sir, this is my passion. What can I do? You're in a very tough situation, bro. I mean, if your parents don't support your passion at this age, it's not an easy journey, and it's never happened to me, so it's very tough to give you an advice. I cannot advise you on something that I don't have knowledge on. As I said before, me personally, I wouldn't go against my parents, because I doesn't make sense to me because they do everything for you literally. So yeah, if they wouldn't support tennis, then I wouldn't play tennis either. Ashish Parida. Hi Ashish, what is routine in Vienna for practice? 2 hours tennis in the morning, 2 hours tennis in the afternoon, and fitness after that. Guhan, see, even they have the courtesy to tag you and send voice notes, but you can't tag somebody on your story and disappoint him. Sorry Guhan to disappoint you. Sham, I train with Suresh Sonachalam, who trains Manish. I've been working very hard and able to win few titles, but had many bad days on the way. Have you been in this situation? Definitely. I mean, everybody has bad days, even Roger does. So don't really have an answer for that. Define the relationship of you and the coach from the earlier stage to the current stage. How coach impacted you in different stages? Raji, Raj Kedam, legend. Hi Raji, Raj Andrew, sorry, my bad. My relationship with my coach, he made me a better person, that's for sure. Whether it affected me as a player or not, he taught me how to behave better, how to present myself better on the court, and that impacted me, and I learned many life lessons as well. So it's more than tennis, I developed as a person. Dear C sir, obviously everybody focuses on court. How to keep that same focus off the court? I don't think everybody focuses on court. It's very few guys in the world who do it, probably 20, 30 or maybe 40. I don't think even somebody 80 focuses on court every time he steps on the court. So that is how I see it. How to keep that same focus off the court? Good question. Again, as I said, to not do stupid shit off the court is for a general healthy lifestyle. You know, it's whether you are a tennis player or not a tennis player, to be online on WhatsApp for the whole day, or to get drunk 3 times a week, or to have bad habits, regardless of tennis or not, you shouldn't be doing it. So what you are off the court is what you are on the court. So off the court, to stay a good human being and to stay responsible is even more important. And if you really love the sport, and if you really want it badly, you will not do anything that hampers your tennis career or any career for that matter. Prashant, how are you killing your time during the lockdown? See you in Pune next year or in Chennai sometime. I am killing my time by annoying my mom and sister at the moment. Ritwik saying, you're my inspiration. Sunny, you're my inspiration. Biggest regret in life, Tarun asking. Biggest regret in life was probably I rushed things in my relationship. I should have taken it more slower. I saw the future way too soon, and I should have taken more time to, we should have taken things slower. So that the impact when it went the bad way would have been less. So that is my only regret so far, nothing other than that. But I don't regret the relationship. I had some great memories, and it taught me many good things, and it made me the person I am. But it's just how I treated it during the end. I rushed it a bit too much. Khatri, can you recommend best sports injury rehab center in Hyderabad? I mean, if you're which physio place? Harini ma'am is very good. There's this physio called Harini. The name is Flexitude. It's in Maratpally. She is very, very good. She is not hyped, so you won't be hearing all those fancy words, but she's very good. Kiran sir, best advice in the last few years? I've got many advices, but when my when one of my coaches in my academy said in November that good players or average players, they enjoy tennis when things are going good, when they are winning, they are happy. Champions enjoy it even in the losses, and they are happy to just step on court. That's the difference, that champions don't let winning, losing affect them as a person. and that definitely is the best advice I've received. What's your pre-match routine? What should we follow? I am very chilled out before a match. There's no routine for me. I talk, I chill, because that doesn't really affect me before a match. So so guys, let's do around 10 more minutes probably. It's been 45 minutes so far, and I think I'm feeling a bit hungry. My stomach is grumbling, so I should probably head for dinner. So last 10 minutes, guys. Tarun asking, how do you manage to be so humble after achieving so much? Two things I can say. First of all, I didn't achieve anything so far. There are more than 250 guys that play better tennis than me. So once I achieve that, let's talk. And I think being humble or being arrogant is a choice of attitude, and it's has nothing to do with what you achieve or how much you achieve. You can be humble after achieving everything. You can be arrogant without achieving anything. It's each person's choice as how he wants to behave. And end of the day, achieving is just a byproduct of your job. So it shouldn't, I don't think it has any connection with a human to how he's behaving. I know guys who don't achieve anything and are arrogant. So it's a choice of attitude. Guhan, enough of tagging. On a serious note, thankfully, finally, what do you think is the difference between a training center in India and say in Vienna, indoor? Because we lose out on almost 8 months in a year because it's extremely hot in India and it's tough to achieve volume. I know you get physically fitter, but it's tough to hit 1,000 balls, if you want to play for 3-4 hours and it's raining for 4 months. So even if we have very good climate, around 5-6 months in India, somebody loses just out on the weather. So that's the biggest difference, that you can play tennis all year. You can play outdoors and then you can play indoors anywhere, even in Spain for that matter. Utkarsh asking, how do you warm up before your match? I sometimes physical warm up, I jog and do all those things. Sometimes I don't play tennis before a match because I don't see how that 5 minute hit is going to change the way I'm going to play. We tried it 6 months back, it works. So unless I really want, I'm really not feeling confident or something, then that's about it. What's your warm-up routine before a match? That's what I answer now. Shyam Sundar, who is your favorite player? I would say Vishnu Vardhan, Yuki Bambri and Prajnesh Guneswaran. I like watching them play for sure. If you see in the big league, of course, Rogers a treat to watch. And I love watching Denis Shapovalov and Felix Aliassime. Definitely. Felix is very good. What are your short-term and long-term goals, Vidya? Short-term goal is to get rid of Corona and get back on court. Long-term goal is to, I don't know, really. Go deep in a slam maybe, or in a big tournament, because nobody in India, it's been a long time, somebody in India has done that. So I should probably take out a top 10 guy or something like that would be good. Win that you cherish the most on the tour beside your matches against Vivi. Win that I cherish the most. Win that I cherish the most, I can't really. Paolo Lorenzi this year in Bangkok, because Lorenzi is, I've been watching him on TV for a very long time since I was young, and to beat him, to play him in real time was phenomenal. To play kind of an idol and to beat him, something that I was very happy that day. DRC sir, it's high time you should open up about your dream girl and when you're getting married and stuff. Whenever my mom approves, sir, she hasn't really started looking yet, and she's not very keen on getting me married right now. But whenever she finds somebody, and whenever she asks me to get married, that would be the time. So it's all in my mom's hands. Vatsal, Duckworth in Pune or Daniel in Pune? Which is a match you think you could have got in the bag more? Regret more? Both, but Duckworth much more. I mean, that was a smash on top of the net. I should not have lost that. I should have won that match 5 times in one match. Daniel in Pune, I mean, it's not something that I messed up. It's just a match, I guess. Could have gone or could have not gone. If not for tennis, what profession do you think you would have pursued asking with? My mom is very patriotic as a person. She always keeps telling me that you should, revive tennis in India, and you should always do something for the country. And, you know, so I think even my dad's a civil servant. So I would have probably wanted to go to the army or done something which would have the flag involved. Raj Kedam, Raji, how Kiran impacted your life? He gave me some hair loss solutions for sure. How Kiran has impacted my life? I think he's taught me a good forehand, that's for sure. The forehand that I have today, it's definitely the basics come from him. Namita, why did you skip today's workout? Namita, I was running outside and I did my strength, but I completely forgot to text you. I'm so sorry. I promise it won't happen again. Ritvik Chaudhary, whiskey taagute kallu potaya. Sorry guys, this is a question that I asked in our WhatsApp group, and the kid inside me came out, and I said something very stupid, which translates to English: if you drink whiskey, do you? Practice focuses on patterns and strategy. Most of it these days, a lot of it. Delisha telling me, haha, I told you marriage would come up at some point. It would, yeah. I knew that somebody would ask me that question. Guhan saying, Mukund, I think it's high time you wind this up and go eat. You look hungry and super sleep deprived. Hey Guhan, no bro, I've been sleeping a lot. I've been hogging food of late. So, no. So guys, that's 3 more minutes. Any more questions? Shoot it. No more questions so far. So thank you. I guess that's the end. Okay, last question. Divyang, future goals for now. I just want to get back on court, bro. Vatsal asking, what you gonna eat? I'm gonna eat rice rasam. Snake gourd, beetroot, and what do you call valakai? I don't know how to call it in English, I guess. Kiran sir asking, biryani or pasta? Come on, biryani any day. I mean, what is pasta? Pasta, shit. Mukund, the real Belde. Mukund, how are you keeping yourself fit? Do you have a routine with your coach that you work with? Yes, I keep myself fit. It's quite tough. Guhan asking, last question. US Open 2021 main draw a possibility? Yes. Going deep into the tournament also a very good possibility. If Corona ends by October and I can get back to the circuit, and next year remains normal, that I can play from January to August. Good chance that I set the screens on fire. But again, anything can happen in tennis. But I wouldn't bet my life against it that I won't pull off something special. I believe it can happen. 2021 is going to be quite a crucial year. Akshaya, my sister, can you forget tennis for a day? Tough time. Dear Sikiran, Saket, Vishnu any day. But sorry, Saki, I love you, but Vishnu is the man. Good center in Chennai for adults. Suresh sir is good, Anna University. Kiran sir, grilled chicken, tandoori. Dear Kiran sir, clay hard, clay, any day. How, Katri, how is the life of a hitting partner in Europe? Any idea? Pretty okay. Utkarsh, how do you train your mind? I mean, I don't have a mind that functions that well, so neither have I trained my mind. DRC Kiran sir, servant volley, aggressive baseline. Ooh, tough choice. I like doing servant volley. I mean, I enjoy it much more, but I suck at it. So aggressive baseline, I guess. Sai Deepya, hi Sai, long time. I've only seen you in Nidhi's comments. Never seen you other than that. So happy you're. Ritvik Chaudhary, Sunny again, Roger, Rafa. Tough call, Roger. Guhan, Vishnu or Bala, the closer friend? Oh god, these are tough questions, bro. Vishnu is a brother, so friend is Bala. Because Vishnu is not my friend, I don't say some things to him that I say to Bala. So I'm quite respectful. Savadika, Sayonara, Kiran sir, who are these? What is this? Who's Savadika, who's Sayonara, I guess? I don't know. I am Mark. Are you avoiding Spain questions? When did somebody ask a question about Spain? Oh, I am. Sorry, I missed that question. Good tennis center in Spain. Oh, I mean, it's been ages I've been in Spain, so. I mean, tough to recommend something. The last time I was there was in 2015, so I don't really know what's the situation right now. DRC Kiran sir, again, Paradise Cafe Bahar. Guhan asking biryani or shawarma? Biryani. And that's it, guys. I've got to go. Instagram is shutting down in 40 seconds. So it's great, and thank you, Indian Tennis Daily. You guys are fabulous. You guys are doing an amazing job. I'm talking on all the tennis players in India on behalf of them, that we are very grateful to you. And if you guys were not there, we wouldn't even be having the publicity that we have today. Without expecting anything in return, you're doing all this for us. So we are eternally grateful for this. And thank you for your effort, thank you for your time, and thank you for having me here. I had a fabulous time answering all the questions, and thank you and goodbye. This is Mukund signing off.